Today, I want to tell you about a problem that I worked on in research on my own with collaborators and with students that we've been stuck on for many years. And I'm talking about, this is groups of 30 to 50 people who still don't know a full answer to this question. So the question can be encapsulated in the following picture. On the left, you have a bunch of circles. There's five of them exactly. And the circles overlap to make an intersection pattern. For example, you notice this blue sliver here that's highlighted. That's a place where sets 3 and 5 intersect, but sets 1, 2, and 4 are not involved whatsoever. We can encode that by a binary string. The string has 5 bits in it, corresponding to the 5 sets we have involved, and we have a 1 precisely if we have the set indexed at that point involved. So for example, the string 00101 indicates that we have somewhere in the diagram where sets 3 and 5 intersect, but 1, 2, and 4 are not involved at all. So if you take a look at the picture on the left, it has a bunch of intersections, and on the right, we have the entire list. For example, this binary string we've listed, 00101, appears highlighted in blue on the right. So the fundamental question in this area of research is, how do you go backwards? If you're given the list on the right of the intersection patterns that you want, how do you actually create a diagram like the diagram on the left? Is it even possible? What restrictions are there? Is there a restriction on the dimension in which you can realize the picture? Here we have a two-dimensional picture, but maybe if you're given a list of binary strings on the right, you can create a picture in higher dimensions. These are the types of questions that we're curious about. So like I've mentioned, this is an area of research that's involved a lot of people. So here's just a few people who've been involved that I've worked with in the past and some of the articles that I have been involved with in working on these projects. And it's been a really interesting endeavor with lots of discoveries that have went well beyond the things that I've worked on. But still, we don't have a full answer to this question. Now, believe it or not, this question's actually motivated by something in science. It turns out that these different regions correspond to stimuli that happen in an animal's brain, particularly in terms of what's happening with their neural firing patterns. And it turns out that these neurons fire in regions in a space that look kind of like these blobs, so they're approximated by circles. So in general, because of these pictures, we don't just assume that the shapes are circles, but they can be what are called convex sets. If you want to learn more about what a convex set is, definitely check out the video linked above here where I have a video talking about what those are. But if you don't know too much about those, you can just assume that they're circles for now. It's going to encapsulate the same idea intuitively. We'll also make an assumption that the borders of these circles are dashed so that you don't have something like two circles intersecting at a point of tangency, which is kind of a degenerate situation. So here's an example of a list of binary strings that actually cannot be realized with convex sets. What that means is, if you have 3 convex sets, and if you want, think of these as being circle or oval-like with no boundary, so they're like dashed lines as boundaries, then there's no possible way for the intersection pattern to look exactly like this list. Let's see why. On the left is the region where you realize the highlighted red code 110, meaning it's a place where the sets 1 and 2 intersect. On the right is a place where the sets 1 and 3 intersect. These are convex, so on the left we can pick a point, the beginning of this dashed arrow, that lies in the intersection of the first and second sets. And on the right, where the head of this dashed arrow is, we have a point that is in the intersection of the first and third sets. So both these points, the endpoints of this arrow, lie in the first set. And the first set is a convex set, like a circle or an oval, so the entire line segment is going to lie inside of that. That means as we traverse from where the first and second set intersect to the place where this first and third set intersect, we have to leave one and go out to the other because we don't have that these sets intersect at a point of tangency like we mentioned earlier. So it must be the case that we travel within this first set, but outside where we strictly have the first and second set intersect and the first and third intersect. So we either go through a space where we only have the first set involved, or we have all three sets involved. But that's not listed in our list of binary strings. It's not part of our presumed intersection pattern. So this list of intersections, as a precise list of intersections, is impossible. So you start to see the complications that arise with this. Let's look at an example of a family of examples where you can actually construct examples that meet exactly the intersection requirements that you have. So if you have at least a few binary strings, and you have the string that contains all ones, like the one right over here, then you can actually construct a picture that works. So the idea is, suppose you have a bunch of other ones, let's say at least three, and here we have exactly four. What you do is you draw a polygon that has exactly the number of sides that equals the number of binary strings in your list that aren't the all one string. So here we have four of them, so we'll draw in a square like we see in this picture right over here. And then we're gonna inscribe this square inside of a circle. That's gonna create four sectors. One sector for every single one of these binary strings that's not the all ones binary string. If we do that, each of these sectors will be labeled. Now we'll collect for each of these sectors certain sets. For example, the first set is going to consist of all the regions in this diagram that have one in the first bit. That's this top region right over here, this right region over here, and the square. So we create this particular diagram right over here. Okay, and we do the same thing for the second bit, the third bit, and the fourth bit. Now, if we put all these together by design, the intersection pattern is going to be exactly what we see right over here, including this all ones binary string. If you want to give a concrete reason why, I suggest leaving your thoughts in the comments and talk about why this actually works. So, of course, the question is, can we find meaningful criteria that guarantee that given a list of binary strings, we can actually construct the pictures? There are many criteria, and here are just some examples of research articles that talk about these. For example, there's one that talks about what happened in dimension one and a complete characterization there. But in general, we really don't know the answer. Do you have thoughts? Do you have ideas of ways in which to create pictures given the list of binary strings? Leave your thoughts in the comments if you have really cool ideas of how to do this.